Welcome to John Lewis 3D Learning. In this presentation, we are going to see acid-basic salts. The topic is definition of bases. So, what is a base in the very first place? A base is either a metallic oxide or a metallic hydroxide or ammonium hydroxide, which reacts with hydronium ions of the acid to form salt and water only. So, what are the examples for metallic oxide? So what is metallic oxide and what are some examples? Any metal with oxygen is known as metallic oxide. Therefore here the example is copper 2 oxide. See, copper 2 oxide is CuO, magnesium oxide is MgO, calcium oxide is CaO. So these are all example of metallic oxide. Then second one is metallic hydroxide. So can you give some example for metallic hydroxide? So it can be magnesium hydroxide. So what is the formula of magnesium hydroxide? MgOH twice, because magnesium valency is 2, hydroxide valency is 1. When you interchange, we get MgOH twice. Aluminium hydroxide, AlOH thrice. How you get this formula? Aluminium valency is 3, hydroxide valency is 1. When you interchange, we get AlOH thrice. What is the third one? Or ammonium hydroxide. What's the formula of ammonium hydroxide? NH4 valency 1. Hydroxide valency 1, if we interchange, we get NH4OH. So which reacts with hydronium ion. What is hydronium ion? H3O plus ion is called hydronium ion. So this is obtained from acid. How? For example, if you take hydrochloric acid, when dissolves in water, that dissociates into hydrogen ion and chloride ion. This H plus ion will combine with water, form hydronium ion, H3O plus ion. Okay, so in order to represent it simply, so we are removing this water and we are simply representing it by H plus ion, hydrogen ion or hydronium ion. Okay, so now let us see some example here. For example, you take copper 2 oxide. See, copper 2 oxide is CuO because valency 2 and 2, so 1:1. If you interchange, you will get CuO. When it reacts with acid, hydrochloric acid, so what happens? A salt and water only are formed. Only salt and water, no other product should form. So therefore here what do you get? Copper 2 chloride you will get. Copper 2 chloride 1. Therefore if we interchange, what is the formula? We get CuCl2 plus we get water. So if we balance the equation, we get 2HCl here. Let us take one more example. This is an example for metal oxide. We take an example for metal hydroxide, MgOH twice. If it reacts with sulfuric acid, instead of hydrochloric acid, we can take any other acid also, sulfuric acid. So what do you get here? Magnesium sulfate plus water. So what is the formula of magnesium sulfate? Mg valency 2, sulfate also valency 2. Therefore, if you simplify, you get 1:1. Therefore, the formula is MgSO4 plus H2O. Okay, if you balance it, you will get 2H2O. That's it. Okay, so one more example we see. AlOH thrice, aluminium hydroxide. Because aluminium valency 3, hydroxide valency 1, we get AlOH thrice. Plus nitric acid we take, HNO3. So here what you get? Aluminium nitrate you will get. Because aluminium is a positive ion, nitrate is the negative ion. Therefore, we get aluminium nitrate. So, what is the valency of aluminium? 3, nitrate valency is 1. Therefore, if you interchange, you get AlNO3 thrice plus water you get. Plus water. So, here what you get? 3HNO3 you'll get plus 3H2O you'll get if you balance it. So, like this, we can go on giving lots of examples. One more example, final example, ammonium hydroxide. You take ammonium hydroxide. NH4OH. So let us take the simple acid, hydrochloric acid. So here what do you get? Ammonium chloride, ammonium valency 1, chloride valency 1, therefore ammonium chloride plus water. So this is automatically self-balanced already. Okay, here ammonium hydroxide, how you got? Ammonium 1, hydroxide 1, therefore if you interchange, NH4OH. So this is also balanced now. So here when the metal oxide or metal hydroxide react with water, what we are getting? Salt and water only. If any other product is formed, then the metal oxide or the metal hydroxide cannot be a base. Okay, that has to be very clear. So because they will ask you questions like this, no, lead 4 oxide is not a base. Why? We know lead oxide is metal oxide, therefore we expect it to be a base. Okay, now what is basic oxide? A basic oxide is a metallic oxide which contains the oxide ion and reacts with acid to form salt and water only. For example, already we have seen copper 2 oxide, magnesium oxide, calcium oxide, all these things are base because they react with acid to form only salt and water, nothing else. Therefore, they are bases. So these are all some of the metallic oxide bases. Okay, one. We see lead 4 oxide is not a base. I already mentioned this question. Lead oxide is not a base. Why? Because lead oxide when react with acid. So what's the formula of lead oxide? Pb valency 4. Lead 4 they are given. Oxide valency we know 2. So if you simplify, you get 2:1. If you interchange, what we get? PbO2. Okay. When it reacts with hydrochloric acid, what are the products formed? Lead chloride salt is formed, very good, and water is formed, okay, good, and along with that chlorine gas is also liberated. Therefore, if you balance this one, you will get 4HCl and 2H2O. So here not only salt and water are formed, chlorine is also formed. Therefore, lead oxide is not a base. Lead 4 oxide is not a base. Is it clear? Only salt and water should form. No, nothing else. No other product should form. So here chlorine is formed. Therefore, lead 4 oxide is not a base. Is that point very clear? It's a very important question because it is an exceptional case. No, therefore they will ask you. So next one, basic hydroxide. What is basic hydroxide? A metallic hydroxide which contains the OH minus ion. A metallic oxide which contains the OH minus ion will react with an acid to form salt and water only. So what are the example we can take? We can take sodium hydroxide plus hydrochloric acid. We can take sodium hydroxide and you take hydrochloric acid. So what do you get? Sodium chloride salt and water only form. So since this is a metal hydroxide, it reacts with acid, forms only salt and water, no other product. Therefore, this is also a base. Sodium hydroxide is a base. Is it clear? Because when it reacts with acid, only salt and water are formed. No other products are formed. Okay, then what is meant by alkali? See, all alkalis are bases. But all bases are not alkalis. They might ask you this question. See, alkali means, alkali is a base and soluble in water. Soluble in water. If it is insoluble in water, it can be a base but not an alkali. A base which is soluble in water is known as alkali. Okay, so an alkali is a basic hydroxide which when dissolved in water produces hydroxyl ions only. No other negative ion will be formed. For example, if you take sodium hydroxide, when it is dissolved in water, sodium positive ion and hydroxyl negative ion is formed. OH negative ion is formed. Only negative ion. Therefore, it is an alkali. That means what? When those bases dissolve in water, they are called alkalis. So let us see some example for alkalis. Maybe this question, along with this question, we can see. All alkalis are bases, but all bases are not alkalis. So from this what we understand, those bases which are soluble in water are called alkalis. All bases are not soluble in water. Okay, that is why all alkalis are bases, but all bases are not alkalis. So let us see some example. Caustic soda, sodium hydroxide. So this is readily soluble in water. This is soluble in water. And since it is readily soluble in water, this is a stronger alkali. And similarly, potash soda, that is potassium hydroxide. So that is also soluble in water, that is also very strong. Readily soluble in water. And if you take calcium hydroxide, so this is also soluble in water, but not as readily as caustic soda or potash soda. Only they are feebly soluble or partially soluble. Therefore, it is a weak. So it is a weak alkali because it is only partially soluble in water. Other example is ammonium hydroxide. So this is also a weak alkali. So it is not completely ionized, no, into hydroxyl ion. Only partially ionized when dissolved in water. Therefore, this is also what? This is also a weak alkali, ammonium hydroxide. Okay, now you take the other two bases, ferric hydroxide and cupric hydroxide, that is iron 3 hydroxide and copper 2 hydroxide. So these two are bases but not alkalis, because both of them are insoluble in water. Both of them are not soluble. They are not soluble in water. Therefore, what it is? They are bases but not alkalis. Hope you understood this, and hope you understood the definition of bases and alkali, everything very clearly. So thank you very much for watching it. If you like it, please click the like button and share it with your friends. Until we meet next time, bye bye.